I'm Janek Kupek, and I'm very often asked how our technology of photon counting detectors works and how it can be used for X-ray radiography. So I decided to show you some small experiment, and I will try to explain the principle and advantages of this technology for X-ray imaging. So I have prepared a very simple thing. Everybody can try it to check. So this is just a lamp. And basically, X-ray radiography works exactly the same way as we know from light projection. So if I would shoot with some source of light to my hand, it would cast some shadow on the kind of sensor. And the sensor for us at the moment is this white plate at the moment. But we see that actually I don't see a really internal structure of my hand, because visible light cannot penetrate through the tissue, so I don't see the bones. For that purpose, we would use, instead of standard light, X-rays, which can penetrate through the tissue, and it would reveal some more opaque structures in the hand, like bones. We know the same thing from visible light, so if I would use something transparent, simulating my hand, like this glass of water, you see it's shadow, actually light can go through. And if I would put into the glass this spoon, so it is in fact like a bone in my hand, we see it actually. So the same way X-rays would penetrate through my hand, through the soft tissue, and it would be more blocked by bones, and we see the structure of bones in the tissue, in the human body. And now actually when we know how the image is created on a certain projection plane, where we have to have some sensitive material to catch intensity of the light or radiation going through our object to be imaged, we have several possibilities. We can use X-ray sensitive films. That's a very old technique which was invented by Wilhelm Conrad Röntgen 130 years ago. Or we can use traditional radiographic device which is used in hospitals, which is called flat panel, or we can use our photon counting detectors. So basically, we can imagine our sensor like this piece of paper. And of course, this piece of paper consists of pixels. So there are many pixels in the plane. I will draw just a few. So there is such a matrix. We need to make it sensitive. So whenever some radiation would fall into one pixel, the pixel has to be able to detect incoming radiation intensity, amount of light or X-rays coming there. And there are basically several principles. So if we would focus to one of those pixels, how to make it sensitive to X-rays, we have options. The first option would be that the pixel basically is covered. So the pixel would be like this, and it would have layers. So the pixel would be like a block, and the first part of that block would be made of scintillating material, which is basically material which converts incoming X-ray photon to visible light. So whenever X-ray photon comes here to that pixel, it would start to glow, so it produces visible light. And this visible light goes to another layer beneath. And the other layer consists of a standard photodiode. So photodiode, which converts this visible light to electrical signal. And the electrical signal has to be accumulated by the pixel. So when actually such detector is illuminated by X-rays for certain exposure time, the current produced by this diode would be accumulated in the capacitor. So the capacitor gets charged. When the exposure time is over, this capacitor would contain certain amount of charge. That means that we can measure here on that capacitor some voltage. This voltmeter would measure certain value. And this value is remembered for that pixel. And if each of those pixels would measure its own voltage, it can be shown as an image of the recorded object like this glass of water or my hand with bones. This is basically analog device. Even when people used to say that they have digital sensor, it is not. The detection actually is done in analog way, and this analog number, the voltage measured on the capacitor, is digitized later. So it is translated from analog value to digital value later during the readout of the image. Then we have actually digital image as we know it from standard cameras we have in our mobile phones. Our technology of photon counting works differently. Again, I would draw a structure of one pixel. So that would be our pixel. Our pixel has also some layers. Instead of scintillator, we have the semiconductor sensor, which is connected to another layer, which is a layer containing electronics for processing of signal from this semiconductor sensor. The final structure works that way, that when incoming radiation comes here and interacts with this semiconductor sensor, it creates directly electrical charge. So there are pluses and minuses generated directly here. There is no visible light created. And then actually those charges are transferred by electrical field. So there is some electrical field which takes these charge carriers and transfers them to the input of this our CMOS electronics, this separate chip. And the CMOS electronics gets this charge and processes it. So within each pixel we have some amplifier which amplifies this pulse. So whenever photon comes, a single photon is coming here, we see it as a charge pulse. It is amplified, and this amplified signal is then connected to the counter, and the counter counts one. There is one photon coming, there is number one. If there are more photons, multiple photons during the exposure time, it counts, for example, number of 1000 or whatever. And then, of course, all those numbers in all pixels would create some intensity map, intensity matrix, which is the image we would like to have. The advantage of this technology is that it is much more noise tolerant. This threshold value here is set for that reason, that it completely suppresses electronic noise. Of course, whenever we are measuring certain electric quantity, we have always some noise. But our threshold is set above of that noise. So the noise itself cannot contribute to the number counted here. It can happen only when there is a pulse which is larger than that noise, which corresponds to photons to be seen, and then those photons are added and counted. The advantage of this technology compared to flat panel, there are few advantages. The main advantage is that here we really count number of photons. We cannot have better precision than knowing the number of photons. In flat panel, we don't really know how many photons came because each photon generates a certain amount of visible light. Then this light has to be converted to electrical signal in photodiode, and then this signal is accumulated in analog memory, which is capacitor, and when measured as a voltage, we don't have a clue how many photons were here. And all those stages are imprecise. So actually, the amount of signal we generate and amount of signal we are storing is always having some noise there. So the voltage measured here is measured always with certain error. And there are also some other disadvantages. If amount of signal is too low, then amount of level of voltage is also low, and we cannot really say whether there are just photons coming or it was complete darkness. And then we say that the image is underexposed. Another extreme is if there would be too high signal, then the capacity of capacitor is not enough to store all the signal there, and we cannot measure it because it is over the saturation level, and we say that the image is overexposed. So at the end, the dynamic range, the range of intensities we can measure is limited. Here, the situation with photon counting is completely different, because whenever there is even one single photon, we always see it as one. There are no doubts, so that it is not 0.5 or 0.3, nothing like that. There is clean digital one. And such one would be remembered here in the digital register forever. So even if the exposure time would be very long, it would still be one. There is no noise, no discharges, nothing like that. And in the case of very high intensity, again, we can count forever. It doesn't matter how many counts we have here. We can have 1 million, we can have 10 million counts. So it doesn't matter. It would always remember clean digital number without any added noise. So these are the main differences between these two types of technology.